It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas everywhere you go. Take a look in the 5 and 10, glistening once again with candy canes and silver lanes aglow. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas, toys in every store. But the prettiest sight to see is the holly that will be on your own front door. A pair of hop-along boots and a pistol that shoots is the wish of Barney and Ben. Dolls that will talk and will go for a walk is the hope of Janice and Jen. And Mom and Dad can hardly wait for school to start again. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Soon the bells will start, and the thing that right within your heart, right within your heart.
close to our hearts and strangers in lands afar, together sharing the joy, Emmanuel. He has come to dwell.
Gathering them, gather around and give. on this lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you.
Sleigh ride with you.
Outside the snow is falling and friends are calling you. Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you.
Giddy up, giddy up, let's go. Let's look at the show. We're riding in a wonderland of snow. Giddy up, giddy up, giddy up, it's red. Just holding your hand. We're riding along with the song of a wintry fairyland. Our cheeks are nice and rosy and comfy, cozy are we. We're snuggled up together like two birds of a feather would be. Let's take that road before us and sing a chorus or two. Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you.
Sleigh ride with you.
Lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you.
Sidewalks dressed in holiday style. In the air there's a feeling of Christmas. Children laughing, people passing, meeting smile after smile. And on every street corner
we
would you welcome the Prestonwood Children's Choir?
Thank you. was a desolate time for the people of Israel. The cruel reign of Herod the Great had left them dejected and downcast. 400 years had passed since they had received a word from God. Enduring wars, political strife, and the onslaught of pagan religions, the chosen people of God began to place their last hopes in the promised coming of the Messiah. The heavens seemingly sat still as a mighty army of angels hovered in place, waiting. Waiting for God to set in motion the events that would bring forth the new covenant. God's promise to reconcile all people from their sins through the blood of His only Son, Jesus Christ. And so the angels hushed in anticipation as they watched Gabriel descend to the Virgin Mary.
Greetings, O favored one. The Lord God is with you. Do not be afraid, for you have found favor. And you will give birth to a son, and you will give this child the name of Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and he
the news of the angel and submitted herself as a servant of the Lord. Together with her betrothed husband Joseph, she made the long journey to the crowded city of Bethlehem, where the only shelter they could find was in a cave on the outskirts of town. In the fullness of time, Mary gave birth to Jesus and laid him in a manger. The heavens were silent no more as the call rang out for the angels to assemble.
Hear me now, O heavenly hosts, great news of joy I bring. On this night upon the earth, the High Prince of Heaven has been born. Gone to dwell among the children of the Lord, for God has chosen him to be their Savior. The time has come, we've waited for this night for so long. It's time to shout. It's time to blow.
Father's seeking people that he wants to worship him.
We should worship at Christmas because that's when God sent his only son, Jesus Christ, to come down in the form of man.
Christmas is the ultimate fulfillment of God's promise.
The joy of Emmanuel, of Jesus with us.
Luke 2:13-14.
Suddenly,
a multitude of heavenly hosts appeared, praising God,
saying,
worshiping Jesus Christ,
appeared, praising God.
And that is what Christmas is truly about.
Singing, glory to God in the highest.
Glory.
Glory to God in the highest.
Glory to God in the highest.
Glory to God in the highest.
For me and you, unto us a child is born this day.
And we join the angels and sing, we celebrate the newborn.
Glory to God in the highest.
life away. Now the world will never be the same.
We sing glory, you're so holy. I worship the one.
son, this manger for your bed. You have a long road before you, rest your little head. Can you feel the weight of your glory? Do you understand the price?
Does the Father guard your heart for now, so you can sleep tonight? Go to sleep, my son. Go and chase your dreams. This world can wait for one more moment. Go and sleep in peace.
I believe the glory of heaven is lying in my arms tonight. But Lord, I ask that He, for just this moment, simply be my to sleep, my son, and baby, close your eyes. Soon enough, you'll save the day. But for now, dear child of mine, oh my.
Christ's birth means to me the beginning of everything that Christ is to us as believers, His love, His graciousness, Him dying on the cross for us, and Him saving us, and saving us from all it is in this world that is darkness.
We should worship at Christmas because it's an expression of love, an expression of gratitude for God sending His Son.
It's a time to realize that God sent His only Son for us, and we have no other way to thank Him or even to express what we feel for Him but to worship.
I just worship Him and thank Him for being there for me at all the times, the hard times, the even good times.
He became poor for our sake so that we could live a life that's pleasing to Him.
The gift of Christmas is just His promise to always be with us and to love us unconditionally no matter what we do.
The ultimate gift was put on this earth so that we may live in eternal life and have eternal life in Christ.
He has completely changed the whole reason why I live and why I go through each day with such motivation.
I just think it's really great that these people who in many situations have nothing can come together and worship as one in love of Jesus.
Christ came to the earth because He loved me and because He wanted me to be in a relationship with Him. He wanted to know me again personally.
It's just a time where we can focus on Him and give Him all the glory He is due.
Christ's birth was an expression of God's love for us. He sent His Son. He didn't have to send His Son.
I just think there should be this uncontainable joy inside of us
that should just overflow into worship. He saved me from sin and death, and that's when he was born.
Because of that silent night, Christ is in our life, and he loves us and saved us, and we have a reason to live.
The greatest expression of love this world has ever known was given.
On this silent night, this holy night, we worship him.
Heavenly peace. My favorite part of Christmas is going to church and celebrating Jesus.
Celebrate Jesus.
Celebrating the birth of Christ.
It reminds me when he was born.
No. I just like Christmas. Celebrate Jesus' birth, and that's all.
My friends and family always celebrate Christmas together with us.
Christmas means to me that God loves me.
I just like it. It's just fun.
I don't know anything else.
My favorite food is waffles or chocolate chip pancakes,
macaroni,
cookies,
the pancakes,
the food.
Talkie.
Christmas cake.
Cookie the milk.
Chicken.
Pie.
Yes, getting presents like every year.
I love Christmas because
getting presents.
Presents.
Presents?
We get to open the presents.
Yeah, I get a lot of presents.
We sing songs and just listen to songs and talk about Jesus and what Christmas really means.
All the carols and the lights and the beautiful singing.
Celebrate with my family.
My parents wake me up and say, Guys, get up, get up. It's time to open our present. And I just be running to the Christmas tree. And it has all those presents waiting for me. I'm like, oh, thanks, that's cool. It's the best part is you get to tear it up. Just see what you get. And
Daddy, does he really just sleeps in?
He usually sits around and watches us open presents.
We kind of drag him out of bed and drag him to the living room.
Does he ever give her any presents?
Only two or three, and that's only every 4 years.
I'm Avery Redding.
My name is Bradley.
My name is Avery.
My name is Crystal Leon.
My name is Delaney.
I'm Cora Chatham.
My name is Joshua Simon.
I love Christmas.
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 And I love Christmas.
I'm Bennett too, and I love Christmas.
I love peace. I love
birth of Jesus Christ changed everything for me.
Christ coming as a baby is the ultimate sign of humility.
This baby has changed my life because he is the only one that is coming back to take me to heaven.
He's what has made me less of Yvonne and more of him. It is his will that lives in me. It is his words that I pray come out of me. It is his smile that I pray people see. It is the joy of being his child that makes my life complete.
The baby changed everything for me. He gave me peace. In Isaiah it says, he will keep in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on him. I have that peace.
The baby has changed everything about my life and my family.
Because he came as a child, he came into the world as we did. He grew, he lived, he experienced all the pains, all the hurt, the love, the joy, the sadness that life has to bring, and he can identify with me.
When I was 23 years old, I accepted Christ as my personal Lord and Savior. And that same Jesus is available to everyone because of God's great gift at Christmas.
When I was first married, my husband and I were not Christians. We came to know the Lord together, and we've had the great blessing of seeing our kids grow and give their lives to the Lord and live their lives for the Lord today. The baby Jesus turned my life completely around. When we came to know the Lord, we made a U-turn, and our life was no longer about self-centeredness, but about Christ-centeredness.
This baby has given me a second chance in life, has given me grace, love.
The birth of my first two children were amazing how they changed everything, but the birth of Jesus in my life changed my life dramatically.
The fact that he chose to send my Savior to me as an infant is precious to me because he chose to send my Savior and your Savior as a precious infant. So my Savior experienced humanity. While he was 100% God, he experienced humanity. I can never say that I can't go to him. I can never say that he doesn't understand.
Teenage girl, much too young, unprepared for what's to come. A baby changes everything. Not a ring on her hand, all her dreams and all her plans. A baby changes everything. A baby changes everything. The man she loves, she's never touched. How will she keep his trust? A baby changes everything. A baby changes everything. And she cries. Oh, she cries. Oh, oh yes. She has to leave, go far away. Heaven knows she can't stay. A baby changes everything. She can feel it's coming soon, but there's no and there's no room. A baby changes everything.
More than 2,000 years ago, a baby was born in Bethlehem, and the life of Jesus changed the world. I want you to think for just a few moments about the best Christmas gift you ever received. Think about the surprise, all the feelings of joy, the excitement as you unwrapped the package and felt the love of the one who gave it. Well, we all love to give gifts to our family and our friends and to show them our love and just what they mean to us. And of course, on a much greater level, that's what God has done for each one of us. That's what God has done for you. He gave you Himself. He gave you His love. Here's the way the Bible puts it in the familiar verse of John 3:16. For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whoever believes in Him would not perish, but have everlasting life. That's the greatest gift, the gift of God's love in the person of Jesus Christ. I want you to know that God can renew your life, change your life, make you a brand new person. He can restore your marriage. He can put your family back together. He can heal your broken heart when you put your faith in Him by turning from your sin and trusting in Jesus as your Lord and Savior. This little baby grew up. He lived a perfect life. He died on a cross. He rose again on the third day. And the Bible tells us whoever calls upon the name of the Lord will be saved. Why don't you call upon His name right now with this simple prayer? Lord Jesus, I invite You to come into my life. I believe that You love me and died on the cross for me, for my sins. I believe You rose again on the third day. And right now, I trust You as my Lord and Savior. Invite Jesus into your life this very moment. Pray and receive Christ. He will change your world. He will change your life and give you a future and a hope with Him.
He came to be so meek and mild, a Savior, yet an humble child, a holy lamb, precious lamb. They called Him the Lamb.
It was the greatest demonstration of love that the world would ever know.
God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. And this Son came as a lamb. He would become a conquering king, but he came as a lamb. He would be King of Kings and Lord of Lords, but he came as a lamb. And he came for you.
People
shepherds came seeking the lamb, and their lives would never be the same. The angelic host formed a choir and lifted their voices from the heavenlies. Wise men were wise enough to seek and bow down to this lamb. He came to seek and to save the lost. He came because he loves you. It's great to know that God so loved the world, but more important to know that God loves you.
Here it is, many years have passed. They say his time has come and passed, but I'm so glad that it still remains.
John looked over the horizon and saw one walking as no one had ever walked. And he said, "Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world." He's still saving, he's still redeeming, and he still is there for you today. Receive him, say yes to him, and he will change your life forever. Time cannot change him, and ages do not time him. He is still the Lamb of God.
Remain standing with us, if you would, for our finale together. We want to invite you to sing along with us these two great carols. Come on, sing along.
Joy to the world.
this great last verse together. He rules the world with truth and with grace. Come on, lift it up and sing it.